This is
Cowboy in the Jungle.
What album was this song?
Is this a quiz?
The answer is Son of a Sailor, 1978.
Okay, I'd have guessed A1A. Okay, it's on Son of a Sailor. Yeah. Okay. So Cowboy in the Jungle was written, and the title I wrote for a friend of mine who was a great sailor. And many years later, I found out before he was a sailor, he actually was a cowboy in upstate New York on a cattle ranch. I never thought of New York having cattle. And we wound up sailing together from Key West to Miami down to the British Virgin Islands. And he was, he had quite a history of going around and stories and things. And going along with that, sometime I was reading this book about Panama and back in the early days when the British and the Spanish were all fighting down there. And it was a great book on Sir Francis Drake, who sacked the town of Portobello where all the money was. It would have been like the Fort Knox of Panama when the Spanish had tons and tons of gold. And I always kind of liked that and wanted to go to Portobello, which I did later on. But between those two things and then living on my boat in the Virgin Islands, that's where the last couple of verses came in. So I took those three kind of sources of adventures and put them into one song.
Well, then how did Montana come into play?
Montana came in, Cowboy in the Jungle also would have been the fact that in 1975, I went to Montana to do the music for Rancho Deluxe that Tom McGuane, my brother-in-law, wrote. And it's still kind of a classic movie out there. It was a very funny movie. And I got into being a cowboy. I had cowboy boots, I had a cowboy hat, went to cowboy bars. And I continued to go to Montana a lot in the summer, even though I was kind of going back and forth between the Virgin Islands and Montana and Key West. So that little song line right there kind of is what Cowboy in the Jungle is about.
So it's about Joe.
He was the first one that inspired it, and he's the cowboy in the jungle that I was thinking about. And I put some other adventures in his life that he didn't have, so I made some up. Sorry. Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
All right. There's a cowboy in the jungle. And he looks so out of place with his shrimp skin boots, his cheap shoes, skins as wide as face. Heading south of Paraguay, where the gauchos sing and shout. But he got stuck in Portobello, where his money all ran. So he hangs out with the sailors, night and day they're raising hell, and his original destination's just another story that he loves to tell. With no plans for the future, he still seems in control, from a Bronco ride to a 10-foot tie. He had to learn to roll. Rolled with punches, made all of his hunches, made the best of whatever came his way. What he lacked in ambition, he made up with intuition. While American women moo-moos talk about all the things they did today. Their husbands quack about fishing as they slurp those long drinks down. This discussing who called what and who sat on whose butt. But it's the only show in town. They're trying to drink all the punches. They all may lose their lunches. Trying to cram lost years into 5 or 6 days. What do you lack in ambition? Erase their intuition. Plowing straight ahead of me. Now I don't want to live on that kind of island. I can count the falling star while the Southern Cross and the Southern Lights, they remind me of where we are. Spinning around in circles, living it day to day. Every 24 hours, could I get 90 good years? It's really not that long to stay. You got the all of your hunches, make the best of whatever comes your way. Forget that blind ambition and learn to trust your intuition. Plowing straight ahead from one man. Script. One thing I left out was the shrimp skin boots. Mm-hmm. I was the king of Mardi Gras and I had shrimp skin boots in my costume. Oh. And they actually were like somebody made, they looked like big giant shrimp. They went all the way up my legs, over my knees, and the toes were the shrimp's heads. And there are pictures somewhere. So if anybody out there has a picture of me at Mardi Gras in, it had to be before 1975. When I was the king of the crew of clones and Jane was the queen and Mike Utley was my consigliere and Bobby Lieberman was the court jester. There is a picture. So that's where the shrimp skin boots came from. And to this day, I've always trusted my intuition.